हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, क्लास 9। टुडे आई एम डिस्कसिंग अवर पार्ट ए, एम्प्लॉयबिलिटी स्किल। ओके, सो आईसीटी स्किल्स मीन इंफॉर्मेशन एंड कम्युनिकेशन टेक्नोलॉजी स्किल्स। ओके, लास्ट टाइम आई हैव डिस्कस अबाउट कम्युनिकेशन स्किल्स, ओके, सेल्फ मैनेजमेंट स्किल्स। नाउ टुडे आई एम डिस्कसिंग अबाउट टेक्निकल स्किल्स। ओके, so because when you want to get a job, okay, an employment, so you must have a good knowledge of communication skill, self management skills, and third, and our technical skills, because we must have a good knowledge how to use internet, how to use word editing software, spreadsheet programs, presentation software. This is a basic technical skill, so you must have a good knowledge about this thing. So today I am discussing about ICT skills, means information and communication technological skills. So in this day you can see and age, machines are versatile. Versatile means all rounder. One thing have capability to perform all type of things, so we can say versatile. As computer is indispensable at home and workplace, means we can say computer is everywhere. The importance of computer we know very well. Okay, so there is no public office to be found that does not use computer. Means computer is everywhere, in government, in private, in semi-government, in our personal use. So we must use computer, mobiles to send and receive our different kind of message in the form of textual, picture, audio, video. Okay, so this is important. Now next thing is convergence is one of the benchmark of today's computer technologies. Okay, so communication is the most powerful thing today's world, but here a computer and internet will help us to send and receive our data with a very minimum amount of time. Okay, so mobile were primarily meant for making and receiving calls. Note, it is also loaded with a lot of applications. Okay, so we know very well, with the help of mobile we can call to another person. Okay, we can send the message, we can check the mails in a one device. So we can ourselves, because in a one mobile we can store lot of apps. Radio is one of the most oldest surviving electronic machine of the pre-computer era, at least in India. So radio technology is our old technologies. Okay, our telephone lines, okay, our pager. So this is old technology, but today we have it electromagnetic waves. We can use digital data. Okay, so this is the one great evolution. Here you can see all the tangible parts means we can capture easily. Okay, we can visible this part of the computer system, no matter how small or big are part of hardware. Okay, because a small device can perform a lot of task. Okay, so we can say example of hardware are printer, joystick. Printer we can use to print our data. Joystick, with the help of joystick we can play games. Plotter, with the help of plotter is also printing device, but it will display architectural design, engineering maps, big advertisement boards. With the help of plotter we can print. And speaker, this is one of the most popular output device. We can listen our audio files with the help of a speaker. So primary memory is so next thing is primary memory. What is primary memory? Is basically electronic memory, we can say. This is a RAM and ROM. The full form of RAM we know very well, random access memory. I repeat, random access memory. And the full form of ROM is read only memory. Okay, so we keep in mind. And but RAM and ROM is a temporary storage media. Okay, but and it will store the small amount of data, but you want to store the large volume of data for a long period of time, so we can use secondary memory. Okay, so secondary memory is for long term storage of information. Our input device are those hardware that takes input from the external world. Okay, so input device we know very well: keyboard, mouse, joystick, mic, okay, touchpad, so light pen, okay, so scanner. So these are all input device to take input of different kind of data directly to the computer memory. Here storage device play important role to store our data, okay, as a device that store the information. Output device are hardware of computer that produce output to be consumed by the external world. Okay, so these thing output device, so we can say the machine will perform three important tasks: inputting, processing and outputting. So we have input device, we have processing device, we have outputting device, but some additional task is storing our data. Okay, this is also important role. So you can see the output device are the hardware of computer that produce output to the consumed by the external world. So what is the output device? Monitor, speaker, printer, these are the important and most popular output devices. Monitor, we can see the output. Printer, we can print our output. Speaker, we can listen our output. Okay, so you can think. Here I'm giving some kind of input and output device example: light pen. Okay, so light pen is an input device. It is used to draw figure on the screen. Okay, plotter, it is used to draw precise picture for the use of engineering applications. Okay, in the exam you keep in mind, suppose to draw figure on the screen, so we can say light pen. Suppose to in engineering applications and to print big data, big images, engineering architectural maps, so we can use plotter. And speaker produce sound output from the screen. So speaker we know very well, we can listen our data. Microphone, sometime also called mic, it is used to taking input as sound. Okay, so microphone is an input device. Scanner is used to produce the digital version of a physical object, mostly a document. Suppose you have a photo, okay, and you want to store in the computer memory, so you can use a scanner, you can use best quality of mobile cameras. Okay, so we directly store our data in the computer physical world data, we can store into the electronic form with the help of a scanner. Printer, we know very well, printer is used to print a document and thus gets is hard copy. Okay, with the help of printer when we can print our data directly and we will get the hard copy. So dear student, today I am discussing about the ICT skills, but here ICT skills require some resources, hardware resources, okay, softwares. So here today I am discussing our input, output and processing devices. Okay, and next time we will discuss more things in detail. Okay student, thank you so much.